Yo, what is going on, you guys? It's your boy Wolfie back at again with another video. I know I've been taking a huge break from YouTube and from streaming, but I don't really have to answer to you guys, and I don't really care to answer any questions about it at the moment. So we're just going to go into this video idea I've had. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how you can universalize your aim between any game you want, between literally could be, it's any shooter game. So any third or first person shooter, it could be Fortnite, TF2, CSGO, Minecraft, Valorant, anything like that. And it should convert just fine. We're gonna use two programs for this. We're gonna use AimLab, and then we're gonna use Kovac Sensitivity Matcher. Hey, this part's just gonna be randomly edited in. So I forgot to mention that this video is gonna be split into two parts. There's gonna be the part with games that use slider for sensitivity, and the part that just use a solid number. Solid number will be first, slider will be second. And yeah, anyway, let's get back into the video. Now, before we start anything, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna go into your control panel. Click mouse, go to pointer options and turn off enhanced pointer position. If you have mouse software, make sure you turn off mouse acceleration in the software too. There's no mouse acceleration on the model, so I don't have to worry about it, but some older mice might have it, so just so you know. Let's go ahead and let's get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to find the game that you want to convert your aim from. So I really like my aim in Valorant, so I'm going to go ahead and open that up. All right, now we are in Valorant, so I want to go ahead and click my sensitivity up here. Click settings. Find my sensitivity. Right now I have it 0.6, and I'm going to copy that to my clipboard, just Control-C. And that's all we're going to do inside the game that you want to convert from. Now, the next thing you need to do is that you need to go ahead and go on Steam and download AimLab, which I talked about in the intro. You're going to need to do it if you're going to do this method. So we're going to go ahead and just open up AimLab. Now, when you first open up AimLab, it's going to have this login screen or whatever. Just hit play offline. You don't need to make an account or anything like that. Just ignore it. It's just trying to get your info to sell. But who doesn't have their info on some sort of marketplace anyway? So when you first open up the game, it's going to have like six different things it's going to want you to do. You can skip them if you want to. I'm into aim training, so I did them. I'm Emerald 4. That's not like a flex. It's just how it is. So if you want to actually use AimLab and do aim training, then you can go ahead and do it. If you don't, just skip it and open up your settings. So go ahead and choose the game profile you want out of all of these. It has literally any game you could possibly imagine. Like, these are just some of the games they have that are the most popular. But if you go down here to game profile filter and show all, there's literally like thousands of games that you can choose from. So yeah, I'm just, for the sake of my sanity, I'm just gonna keep it on show popular. So Valorant's the game I want to convert from, so I put my 0.6 sensitivity in here. Don't worry about all this stuff down here, it doesn't apply to us. Now you're going to want to go ahead and choose the game you want to convert your sensitivity to. So for my example, I'm going to click Team Fortress, and there we go, the sensitivity is 1.909091. Now, I will like to note that for some games that have, they use the same engine, will have the same sensitivity sometimes. It depends. It's really dependent on the game. Like Team Fortress 2, Apex Legends, Quake, Diabolical, CSGO, all of those use like a Quake source sort of type of engine, so all their sensitivities are the same. So yeah, that's just something to know. I can't really tell you guys every single possible like variation of different engines and how similar they are, but it's always best, if you're not too sure, just to open up this and just check. Like, if I open up Diabolical, like, it has a certain yaw multiplier. Like, there's just certain variations to the sensitivity. But yeah, so now that you have your sensitivity that you want to convert to, you want to get out of AimLab. So just like I did right here, you're going to want to open up the game you're converting to Steam. So I chose Team Fortress 2, so we're going to open up TF2. Okay, so here we are on TF2. If you know TF2, you know this is not vanilla TF2. I have my own custom scripts and HUDs going, but so you want to go into your settings on TF2. Again, this isn't the default location of the settings. It's just where mine is because of all my custom stuff. And you want to go into your settings in whatever game, go to mouse or whatever it's called, find your mouse sensitivity, paste it in here. I already have mine inside an autoexec or a config file, which is the number we copy pasted. It just rounds it up just to display it in the menus. But if you're really superstitious about the sensitivity and if it actually matches, you're going to want to open up some sort of empty map, some sort of like training mode map. So for TF2, you open up the console, type map in the map name, or open an empty server or something. If it has a training mode, which TF2 doesn't have a real training mode, then you can use that. I'm just using this for example. Once again, the specifics aren't important right here because there's so many different games you can apply this to. Once again, you don't really have to follow this step. I'm just doing it so I don't have to worry about a timer interrupting me. So yeah, once you're in whatever training mode, empty map thing that you want to be in, you're going to want to find some sort of empty spot in the map that you can use as a point of reference. So right here, I'm going to use the corner of this railing. Now, what we're going to go ahead and do, we're going to go ahead and open up that Kovac sensitivity matcher I mentioned earlier. Now, next, you're going to want to find whatever gamer engine you have your current sensitivity you want to test in. So we have Quake Source. You're going to want to paste the sensitivity into the sense. That's not right. There you go. So now it's going to imitate the sensitivity you just put in. So there's a lot of different keybinds inside of this. We don't really need to worry about this right now. What we need to worry about are just Alt backspace and Alt shift backspace. Those are the only two keybinds you're going to need if you're going to be testing Kovac sensitivity matcher. If you're going to be using it to actually match sensitivity, that's a whole other story. If you're interested in learning how to do that, then let me know in the comments and I'll do a video about that. But for now, we're just going to be using this to test the sensitivity. So the point of us using it to test the sensitivity is actually sort of a replacement of the old school way where before we had stuff like this, you'd actually use a ruler across your mouse pad and you'd measure the distance it would take to 360, but that's set to all sorts of different types of human error. So yeah, it's just better to do it this way. So now that you have the point that you want to choose as your like reference point, you're going to go ahead and open up Kovac. Once you have Kovac opened, you're going to want to hit Alt backspace and it'll do a perfect 360 with no affecting the Y. It'll only change the X. So yeah, so we do Alt backspace and it will always go back to that same spot every single time. And just to be extra sure, you can do Alt shift backspace and it'll do 22 rotations. So the reason you'd want to do that is like, if you know the difference between like magnetic north and north, magnetic north is kind of like this, which doesn't seem that bad, but the further out you go, the more the difference between the smaller degrees actually makes a big difference on bigger amounts of turns. But as you can see right there, it didn't change it at all. So that means our sensitivity is perfectly, you know, done. If you want to like do some sort of like ADS, you know, sensitivity matching, you can do that too, which oops, I think I actually just crashed the game. No, I didn't. Which for TF2 is a little bit weird because of how TF2 handles, you know, scope sensitivity and all that stuff. But if you want to, you know, you can definitely try it. Mine's definitely not matched up, but that's fine. So yeah, that's the basic stuff. So there's going to be, however, that's the basic stuff covered. But there could be situations where it gets a little bit more complex where you actually need to open up config files. So let's go over one of those situations. If we check back in AimLab, you know, we have the same sensitivity, you know, if we go back to Valorant, you'll see it's still 0.6, so say we want to change it to Minecraft, say we really want to get really, really good at Minecraft survival games, and we want to keep our aim from whatever game we're coming from. Well, the issue is that for games that use a percentage instead of just a regular number for their sensitivity, it's not going to perfectly convert. Like, you can't do a 42.368 percentage in game on the slider. You can only do whole numbers. So instead, what you want to do, you want to change your in-game into a config file, and that'll give you this number right here, which you're just going to want to copy. And then I'm just going to quit out of AimLab for now. But now, for every single game, the location of the config file and where the sensitivity is in specific is different. I know Fortnite has a specific file that you need a special program to open. Apex Legends is just like a autoexec.cfg, but other games it's a little bit more complicated. I'm just going to do Minecraft because everyone knows the game directory from Minecraft. So if we open up just run percent app data percent slash dot Minecraft, you know, everyone knows this if you've ever played Minecraft before. Go down to our options, And then we do Control F, sends. Oop. Going down. We see mouse sensitivity right here. Just copy paste, but mine's already perfect. It has a little bit extra because of just the way Minecraft works, but it's the same, trust me. And then once again, if you want to test it, because I definitely understand, like, changing config files can make you feel a little bit sketch. Like when I originally set up my TFT2 config and all the graphics and binds and custom crosshairs and stuff, I was super sketched out about it. So I can totally understand wanting to test it. So if you want to test it for Minecraft, you want to go to single player. I already have a blank world set up to do this, but you just want to make a super flat world and super flat world, just do /difficulty peaceful, just so I don't have to deal with all the slimes. And then what I did when I originally matched my sensitivity is that I put some fence posts up, looked up in the corner, and then once again with Kovacs did alt backspace. Always was in the same location, alt shift backspace, do the 22 rotations, and then once again it's in the corner of the fence. So yeah, that's what I did. That's how you convert your sense between any game. There are some games which are a little bit weird about it, which if you want me to cover those games, make sure you let me know in the comments below. But otherwise, if this video helped you, make sure you liked. If it didn't help you, make sure you dislike. And in a comment below, what else you want to see from me from the channel? I don't really know what I'm going to do with it right now. I think it's going to be like a generic FPS gamer aim channel right now. But let me know your ideas for where I have to take this channel. And yeah, see you in the next one. Peace. Nobody likes you when you're 23, and you still act like you're in freshman year. What the hell is wrong with me? My friends say I should act my age. That's about the time that she broke up with me.